Now, BMWs of a certain age are known to carry some baggage. Now, our car has an epic engine. That's an S52, and it's pretty much bulletproof if you look after it. The baggage on our car is the chassis. It's the platform itself, because it's an E36 platform, which has a reputation for having a little bit of a strength issue. Now, you can fit some aftermarket bits, which somebody has done on this car. They've put these strengthening plates in the strut towers. It's just a bolt-in aftermarket kit. On top of that, they have also fitted this strut brace here, which helps strengthen the front end. Now, it's this section here, this kind of folded box section, that's the Achilles heel on the E36 platform. So there's the weak point, this folded channel here, and in particular, this bracket that holds the diff, it's just not strong enough.
First off, I'll have to get the exhaust out of the way. Then there's the heat shield. And the drive shaft. The CV joint or axles are always a bit of a pain. With the axle separated from the diff, and the diff almost ready to drop, I can slide in the trans jack to help carry some weight.
Not thinking about it, my best guess is that this space here is where the anti-roll bar would have lived. Because that bracket's broken, it would have made it loose, and ultimately, as the car's bumping up and down, it would have chafed against this metal and compounded what was already a BMW issue.
Remove the last couple of bolts, and the heavy lump of the diff can drop out.
I'm going to reinforce this whole section.
I need to cut some material away to get back to decent metal. The BMW's engineering was challenged by the increase in power put out by the M series. Couple that with enthusiastic drivers, well, the weakest link will be exposed. To address the clown shoe, I must first remove its sole. And by sole, I mean the subframe mounting bracket.
I'm now going to be using a very specific drill bit, which is this. So this is designed specifically for drilling out spot welds, and you can see how it works. It's kind of like a mini hole saw. This sharp pointy bit touches against the spot weld. It's actually spring-loaded. So as you add pressure, it engages the saw bit, and it works like a hole saw. It cuts around the spot weld, leaving the spot weld on the chassis, while you can pull the panel away. It's a cool bit of kit.
Always wear protective goggles when you're drilling above head height like this. Burning hot shards of steel does not feel nice in the eyes. The spot weld drill bit isn't foolproof. You might need a hammer and chisel behind the plate to persuade it all the way off. Car frames and chassis do twist and bend a certain amount when the car is being driven. Manufacturers know this and they have to account for it during construction. BMW, however, have had problems in the past not anticipating it properly. With the plate out of the way, the little spot welds can be ground out.
Well, that bracket that I've removed, this one, now, this is pretty much bog-standard steel. The difference is it's quite thin. Now, I'm going to be putting loads of steel back. It's just going to be thicker than this. Now, cars like this are deliberately driven with spirit. Combine that with the fact that it's made out of rather thin steel, and of course you're going to have a problem. I've removed all the underseal and the primer back to bare metal. And then this goes right there.
The steel that I'm adding is thicker than what BMW originally used, at 1/8 of an inch or just over 3 millimeters. I've drilled holes in my new plates and I'm welding through these holes onto the steel unibody. This technique is called plug welding.
I'm just going to let that cool for a second, but it's actually a good time to bring the diff in and work out that upper bracket.
It's so much easier to make a cardboard template, then match that later in steel. Cardboard's definitely easier to cut. And just tack the new diff mount in place.
Now I need to drop the diff, fully weld this whole area up, give it a lick of primer and paint. There's no way that's breaking in a hurry. Whew, and that is it. We can now sell this car with the subframe reinforcement done. Now, I'm actually not going to be putting this differential back in the car just yet. I'm going to keep it out of my way while I get my head around the next bit, the missing anti-roll bar. Now, that is the rear anti-roll bar system assembled. Perfect. I'm not actually going to weld these on straight away. I might as well, while I'm here and I'm in the mood, add a little bit of strength here and here. This chassis area is going to be extra strong and a perfect base for me to mount my new brackets. Thing is, though, I'm not actually going to fully weld these on just yet. I'm going to line it up and I'm only going to put a tack weld on for now. And the reason is that inside here is that rubber, and if I fully weld it, it's going to melt the rubber. Those tacks are certainly strong enough to hold it into place. So if I now drop the anti-roll bar, get those vulnerable rubbers out of the way, and I can weld it up fully. Tack welding is still very strong. In fact, 1 inch of linear weld is enough to hold 1 metric ton of force. 4 small tacks is more than enough to hold this bracket in place. And that is all my welding finished. That's an awful lot of strength to add to a chassis.
Click here to subscribe.